The wind's sort of blowing north, so it's pretty well coming straight down our driveway into the machines.
This sucks. I don't even see where I'm bloody loading.
Well, man, there's that much coming out of there. When it gets windy, it just blows in everything. Every little nook and cranny you could think of, there's dust and dirt in there. The elements out here, they break people, they break machines.
We're just going to put a few buckets through, run it, and we'll see what happens. But, yeah, it's not looking good so far.
The Blacklighters. Mark Iansen, Paul Coon and John Nasser's season is off to a disastrous start.
You've just written off my wife's car, man.
That's something I'd expect from my teenage kids, not you lot. It's been a tough year with the Land of Promise not producing as much as was promised from it.
We did spend a lot. I think that's probably up near 50, 60 grand now. So, I mean, we sort of recovered that, but we'd rather that in our pocket than in the ground.
Got a massive tribe, so we've got to find Opal to feed the family for sure. And oh, that family's getting older and they're getting more expensive to feed.
Did you take the batteries out?
No. Why? The dozer had a couple of issues with the starter button, so until that thing's back up, fixed and running, we go to Opalzilla.
We're not expecting to hit our target alone just with noodling. We're here for big pockets. Dozer's a necessity if you want big pockets.
We don't know what's going to happen with this thing now, so find an opal pretty much out here is the only way to get yourselves out of a hole.
Righto, Mark, gonna fire up, let's see what happens,
eh?
Yep. And I'll put a few more buckets in, we'll just
try, eh? We gotta get some opal, man.
Their noodling machine, Opalzilla, removes dirt and dust from rock, allowing ultraviolet black light to hit the surface of any exposed opal, causing it to fluoresce, so John can snatch it off the belt.
Pretty noticeable, so, I mean, you can see that, you know, it's pretty different to every other rock, so we're slowly plodding away.
Oh, man, this sucks. John, I've just put the last bucket in, man. It's out of control out here, right? I can't see a bloody thing.
Righto. Shut it down if you come out of.
We do sort of try push it as much as we can to get working, but when you're risking the generator loader, it's not worth destroying them just for a day's noodling.
Anything come through?
Oh, a few bits and pieces came through.
The Blacklighters have been forced to shut down after only an hour of work due to 40 kilometre per hour winds blasting their claim and heavy machinery.
That's not worth the dusting, mate. It's not worth killing the machine for this. Yeah, I would have liked to have got a really good day's noodling in here. There's plenty of material around here, but this wind just won't let us do it properly, so it just ends up dangerous and bad on the machinery. I think the only thing we can really do, like now the Land of Promise has dried out, let's go hit that tonight and blacklight it, get the ripper going, the excavator's still close by.
There were still bits of trace.
We just can't sit around. The season goes so fast and then it gets too hot. You can't work, so we've got to make the most of it. Having a big family is not an easy thing. You've got to keep bringing money in.
The Blacklighters are returning to last season's project, an 18-metre-deep open cut they were forced to abandon due to flooding and cost blowouts.
We're just cleaning out the silt and the crap off the bottom. It's still pretty muddy down there, but, yeah, I mean, we can't rush it.
Get this all set up before it gets dark would be good. I don't want to box myself in here because the machine needs to get out of here at the end of the night, so got to be careful where I put the dirt.
Without Opalzilla to process the dirt, they'll need to work at night using handheld ultraviolet black lights to make any opal fluoresce.
When you see material, it really glows. That's why nighttime is just a necessity. There's no point digging a hole like this and then going through the level in the day and missing half of it, you know?
Rightio, Paul, you keep hanging to your right-hand side, mate. I'll keep an eye on this side.
I'm pulling my undies.
Oh, I can see it all just shaking as you've gone over it.
I didn't like that hill. Going well, mate. That was good, man. Good.
You can see rocks coming off.
Yeah, I could see them.
You can, like, feel it sort of vibrate as you're going through it.
Well, better than expected, but Jesus, I look down when you never look down.
With the 20-ton excavator now at the top of the crumbling ramp, the Blacklighters can attempt to extract seam opal out of the concrete-like mine wall.
Just go thin on it to start with.
Just don't stand too close. Something might fall down.
We're just going to rip this bit of seam we found in the wall, so we'll see what's in there.
Did it thicken up?
Got thicker.
Oh, good picking, John. I heard it.
She popped.
Don't know if she's got what we want, though.
Tiny bits.
Tiny bits.
Or you get your light off and bloody get the black light back on.
Oh, there's another chunk. What are we looking at?
It's like a little blob that
little
popped.
Blob, man.
I think we need to take another bite of that. Oh, hang on a minute. That's red crystal, man.
Oh, I don't know if you're going home tonight.
Make sure you put your padlock on your pocket, Mark.
During the day, we would have missed that.
Freaking awesome. Land of Promise pays
out. Land of Promise still going.
Still going
that's
strong.
That's a sick colour, eh?
That's just beautiful colour, man.
That is killer.
That's worth ripping this whole mountain to pieces to find some more of that. That is tops.
That's what we dream of finding.
I know it is.
We finally find some. I want us to get the right money.
I understand that, but if you want to keep mining, we need money for diesel. It's that simple.
After working through the night blacklighting, Mark and his wife Rachel Ianson are desperate to sell their opal haul for some fast cash.
Boys are out working the noodling machine. They're just trying to push through as much dirt as they can. We're trying not to stop at all this year. We've got to sell some opal, keep the money coming in. To support everyone, you know, John, Paul, all the kids. It's a massive pile of pressure that's on us at the moment.
Knock, knock.
How you going, mate?
Hey, Andy.
Good to see you.
How you going? Hey, Rach.
We've known Andy for quite some time. He's a good miner on the fields, but he actually cuts a lot as well and sells his cut stones. So I'm looking forward to seeing if what we've got is what he's after.
Have a look at this. Look at that stuff, Roll.
Oh, nice.
It doesn't spit out this sort of colour very often.
Wow. That's why we come here.
The Blacklighters have high-quality crystal opal featuring the full spectrum of colours. It's in the rough and weighs 70 grams.
OK, so how much are we talking about?
We could probably do 20 grand. But, like, that stone there, when it's cut, that is just going to be the most beautiful crystal.
Yeah, look, I understand that, but it could take me a while to sell these stones. What about 10,000?
No, Andy, I can't. That's crazy.
You know what it's like. You go out and try and find some tops like this. It's pretty hard. But
I need a bit of gravy.
That's what it's about. It's about doing business, isn't it? Well,
sure. I'll come up to 15. I'm feeling a bit generous. It is really nice stuff. What do you say?
Look, mate, I don't know if Mark's really going to like this, but I'll let you have it for 17.
17.
That's it. I can't negotiate anymore. I really can't.
All right. Let's say 17. But look, if you find any more stuff like this, I want to be. Call me first.
No worries. You're going to be number one to see it first.
Thank you.
All right, mate?
Thank you. I appreciate that. All right. Beautiful. 17.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you. Thank you, Rachel.
No worries, mate. You're very welcome.
We're in a tough economy at the moment, but inflation is a little bit difficult. But if you don't spend a little bit of money, you're not going to get what you're looking for.
Andy got some beautiful opal, that's for sure. We don't find that very often. Hopefully we will find it again, but, yeah, I'm not holding my breath.